Okay, more on issues with the New York Post's reporting. So this is according to the New York Times reporting. Many Post staff members questioned whether the paper had done enough to verify the authenticity of the hard drive's contents. This is according to 5 people with knowledge of the tabloid's inner workings. I love the New York Times just calls it a tabloid there. That's funny. Staff members also had concerns about the reliability of its sources and its timing. Okay, so timing is 2.5 weeks out from an election. That seems like kind of an issue. Sources, Steve Bannon, Rudy Giuliani. I mean, which is worse? The one guy facing federal charges and who's a white nationalist goon, or the big drunk who might or might not literally be a vampire? I don't know, but those are among the two less credible sources. Rudy Giuliani's two Ukrainian friends I would trust more.
I'm going with vampire drunk on that, right? Like, I would like if you Bannon had to more, pick.
What? I think I'd trust Bannon more.
No.
Because
there's too much riding, there's too much in it for Bannon. But like vampire drunk just like wants to get, you know, effed up and like hang upside down. Like hang upside down and like do a kegger. Like that dude has less to like, there's fewer stakes, you know what I'm saying? So I'm going vampire drunk on this. But poll, I'm gonna poll in the chat. One.
Let's do that. Who do you trust more?
One for Bannon, two for Giuliani. White supremacist under federal indictment, vampire drunk number two.
Okay, there is nothing I love more than the fact that you are not only calling for a poll, but you did it the way we do it, the ones and twos. I love it.
I know.
Let's see what we got.
It's like I do okay, this I'm show seeing, every Monday.
You do. I'm seeing some threes and fours. What the hell, people? What the hell? Two is Giuliani, right?
Yeah.
I think three is beating one, let alone two. Two is definitely beating one. I see a couple ones. Okay, I've been overruled. Okay, people trust the guy who can't go into the sun more than the guy who looks like he like floated for weeks on a raft in the Pacific Ocean. But anyway, there are other problems with this story. So here we go. Listen to Giuliani. Mr. Giuliani said he chose the post because, quote, either nobody else would take it, or if they took it, they would spend all the time they could to try to contradict it before they put it out. Which is a funny way to say, check if it's true. Anyway, so that's sort of giving the game away. As the deadline approached, editors pressed staff members to add their bylines to the story. Let's pause there for a second. We'll come back to that graphic in a second. If the editors are having to try to push people into putting their names on a story, maybe the story's not credible. Maybe it's not. Anyway, and at least one, aside from Mr. Golding, refused. So Mr. Golding's the one who actually wrote it. He refused to have his name on it. Someone else refused. A Post spokeswoman had no comment on how the article was written or edited, although we already understand quite a bit of it. Now, it did in the end have two bylines. The article appeared Wednesday with two. Emma Jo Morris, a deputy politics editor who joined the paper after 4 years at Fox News. Ms. Morris did not have a bylined article in the Post before Wednesday. That was her first one.
Wow.
She arrived at the Post in April after working as an associate producer on Sean Hannity's Fox News show, according to her LinkedIn profile. Her Instagram account, which was set to private on Wednesday, and here's why, included photos of her posing with the former Trump administration members, Mr. Bannon and Sarah Huckabee Sanders, as well as Roger Stone Jr., a friend and former campaign advisor to Mr. Trump. So two names. The first one literally just stopped working at Fox News for Sean Hannity, an unofficial advisor to the Trump campaign, and routinely parties with Steve Bannon and Roger Stone. The other name, Gabrielle Fonrouge, found out her byline was on the story only after it was published.
Jesus. I mean, just generally, if for those journalists there, people know how journalism sort of works. Usually when you work on a story, you want your name on it. You're proud of it. Hey, if it is, you know, a true story, if it really is credible, if it has potential to shape the election and inform the American public, you'd want your name on that, right? I mean, yeah. In 2016, people jumped over themselves to put their name on things. It didn't matter really what it was about. I mean, it was, but like, I don't, again, part of me is like, is this because they don't want to face the backlash? No, it's not. It's because the only person who did want their name on is totally part of the Trump clique. And the poor other person didn't know until they saw the actual article printed. I mean, it's thin, it's paper thin, and it's ridiculous. And I'm sad actually that some journalists sort of started to fall for it last week. And yeah. I'm glad they kind of pulled back from the brink. Because again, we could have been in another sort of Comey-esque Hillary's email situation.
And that is the perfect example. I have been so worried that the media is going to be like, because most of the media doesn't like Trump, obviously, we get that. But we also know who they are, that they're going to be watching week after week as the polls are still consistent with Biden having a lead. And they're going to be like, I need me some drama. There's got to be something. I want to show how objective I am. But thankfully, they haven't totally gone in for it yet. There's still time. And they're definitely going to have a day or two of going in for it when Trump announces next Wednesday that there's a vaccine that's imminently available. So get ready for that. That's going to be fun. But anyway, yeah, thankfully, people other than the New York Post, people are approaching this with quite a bit of skepticism, which is deserved, considering the timing, the sources, and also factoring in the stakes. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.